In this video, we're going to talk about requirements and traceability. First, we're going to see how requirements are managed in Codebeamer. Then we're going to create some requirements. We're going to derive some requirements from existing requirements. And lastly, we're going to create some test cases that are verifying those requirements. In the end, we're going to visualize the traceability from the top level requirements all the way down to the test cases. But once we're in Codebeamer, let's navigate to the trackers tab. I'm going to show you how I currently have my requirements set up. So I'm going to open the configuration diagram. First, we're going to create a customer requirement specification. From that, we're going to derive a system requirement specification. And lastly, so that we have a three-level requirement structure, we're going to create a system architecture type of requirement as well. And to have our test case, we're going to use the system integration tests. So as you can see on the screen, we're going to have the traceability from the top level customer requirement specification through the different levels of requirement until the system integration tests. Once we have our customer requirement specification tracker open, as you can see, there are already some requirements created, but we're going to create a new one. In the top left corner, we have this plus button, and by clicking on that, we have immediately the options to populate our new requirements. So for the title, I'm just going to say automatic parking. The description is going to say to be done because it's not relevant for our demonstration. Once that's done, on the top, we can click the save button and our requirement is immediately created. It's going to be visible in the middle section, but also it's going to be visible in the tree structure as well. As we saw earlier, we'd like to create different levels of requirements. So by clicking on the plus button next to my requirement, I have the options to derive different type of items from my current requirement. In our scenario, we're going to use the system requirement specification. So by clicking on this, it's going to create a new system requirement specification that is derived from the current requirement that we just created. Once I click that, I have this pop-up window where I can provide the details of our requirement. So since it's the next level, I'm just going to name it Advanced Automatic Parking Assist System, and the description, I'm just going to leave it as is. So if I click on the Save button, again, our new requirement is going to be created, but this time it's going to be in a different tracker. So let me select the automatic parking custom requirement, the first requirement that we created. And if we take a look at the right side here, which is the details of this automatic parking, we can immediately see that there is a new downstream reference that is pointing to our advanced automatic parking system. So if I click on that, this requirement is going to be opened. And we can see that currently we are in the system requirement specifications tracker. So let me click that, and with that, we're going to be navigated to the system requirement specification. And here, the last item on the left is going to be our new system requirement specification that we just created. We're going to do the same thing, but this time we're going to derive a system architecture type of item. Again, we have the similar pop-up window. We need to populate the name. I'm just going to call it Advanced Sensors. And I'm just going to save it similarly just to what we've done before. Pretty much the same thing happened, but with different trackers. So if we take a look at the right side here in the details, we have our advanced automatic parking assist system. And if I scroll down here in the downstream references, we have our advanced sensors created. Also, it's worth noting that we can see the upstream references as well, which is going to point to our custom requirement specification. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm opening the Advanced Sensors System Architecture requirement. And by that, I can navigate to our System Architecture Tracker. The same thing again. In the tree view, we can see our newly created requirement, which is also visible in the middle section here. And on the right side in the details, we see the upstream references that is pointing to our system requirement specification. So now we have the three-level requirement structure from the customer requirements through the system requirements and lastly to the system architecture. What we need to do now is to create our test case. Similarly to before, I have the option to click on this plus button and we're not only able to derive requirements, but we can also derive the test cases as well. And as we've seen at the beginning, we're going to use the system integration tests. So if I click on that, going to have a different type of pop-up window because we're creating a different type of item. So this time we're not creating a requirements type, but we are creating a test case type. I'm not going to go into details on how to populate this because there's going to be another video. So let me just go ahead and save it. And by doing so, our test case is going to be created. And similarly, if we take a look at the right side in the details, we have our new downstream references, but this time this is a test case type of tracker and not a requirements type of tracker. Similarly, if I click on this, we can see the details of our test case. Now that we created all the levels of our requirements and the test case that verifies that last level of requirement, let's see how the traceability works. I'm going to go to the traceability view, which is available here in the top right. This is going to be available in most of the tracker types. So let me click on that. And I have a traceability report created, so we can easily visualize how the traceability is between our items. I'm going to open this report, and it's immediately visible that we have four columns here, starting from the customer requirements, then the system requirement, then system architecture, and lastly, we have our test case. And if you remember the example that we just used, we started with automating parking. From that, we derived the advanced automatic parking assist system. From that, we derived the advanced sensors. And lastly, we created the test case that is derived from our system architecture.